Hear me, saints of God. Good morning to each and every one of you. And I want to say welcome. Today is Sunday, the 22nd of October. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Thank
Praise
you,
the Lord. I say to you this morning, come into his presence, heart open wide. In this moment, let nothing hide. With open minds and spirit free, we find our truth in unity. In this space, let love abound. In every word, in every sound, with grateful hearts, we lift our voices. Hear our cry, O Lord. In worship, we all make this choice. So join with me, hands clapping, both young and old. In worship, let your story unfold. Together, we find strength anew in this gathering, me and you. For we know his faithfulness is true. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I want to welcome Sister Naomi and the worship team as they come now to lead us in song.
Good morning. Good morning to everyone here
Good
in the sanctuary
morning. Good morning.
And online. We are here today having experienced inclement weather for the past week. Of Tammy was at the forefront of our minds. We prayed that God would keep us
Amen.
And all in our island safe,
Amen.
And he heard our prayers.
Amen.
And this morning we are here in the sanctuary and online to give him thanks and praise.
Hallelujah.
Praise God that you know what he has done.
Amen.
He has proven himself
Amen.
Time and time again.
Amen.
Coming to his presence.
Amen.
Yeah.
Lord, bless your name this morning, God. You are worthy.
We serve a God that is able.
Thank you, Jesus.
A God who can.
Hallelujah.
And a God who will always make a way where there seems to be no way. When we are able to see the path ahead, we are unable to see the path ahead because whatever we are going through has blinded us.
Thank you, Lord.
God makes a way.
Amen.
He clears the path.
Thank you, Lord.
He guides our steps.
Amen.
He takes our hand and leads us in the path of righteousness.
That's right. Hallelujah.
For there, He is there for us.
Yes, He is.
Like only He can.
Amen.
He's a wonderful Father.
Yes, He is.
So let's sing that, and we know that we have a way maker.
We bless your name this
morning. A way maker.
Hallelujah.
A way maker.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You're making a way, God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I ask you,
you are here.
Way maker. worship you. You are here, meeting every need. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, touching every life. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, meeting every need. I worship you. I worship you.
Thank you, Lord. You are indeed worthy, God.
Psalm 34:6 says, this poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and delivered him out of his troubles. Job 29:12 says, because I delivered the poor that cried, and the fatherless, and him that had none to help him. What are you crying out to God for today? Whatever the need you have, know that when you cry out to God, he will hear you and will act on your behalf. He will never fail you yet. He has never failed you yet. And he will not start now.
Amen.
Trust him with whatever you bring to him. Amen. And watch him work it out on your behalf.
Hallelujah.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good.
Hear Hallelujah. My cry, O God.
Thank you, Jesus. You are indeed worthy, Lord. Be blessed. Thank you.
question for you this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
And I hope we can all answer in the positive. Is there anybody here who has never proven the faithfulness of God? Good. I like that. He is faithful because he knows no other way. He will continue to be faithful because he is God. It's a part of his character to be faithful to us, so that we in turn will be faithful to him. We want to thank God this morning for his faithfulness that is unfailing. We want to praise God for his faithfulness.
Father, there is no
to praise God for this morning. Great is his faithfulness, and I'm sure that each and every one of us, when we examine our individual lives, we can say that God has been faithful to us. Collectively, we can say thank you, Jesus, for protecting us through the last hours of rain, thunder, lightning, but God has protected us. He is with us, and we ought to give him praise. We ought to give him thanks because he continues to be faithful. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Bow your heads with me. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for this day. Thank you, dear God, for your mercy. Thank you again for your protection. Thank you for your love. You continue to be faithful to us even when we are faithless. And Lord, we want to thank you. Thank you, dear God, for protecting us through the couple hours, the last hours, through this season even, Lord. We want to thank you, dear God, for protecting us. And even now, dear Father, we come on behalf of those who might be experiencing the extreme weather, dear God. During this system, I pray, dear Father, that you would be with them and help them, dear God, to remember that you are with them even in the storm. You are there with us, and we can cry out to you. We can bring our petitions to you, and you can hear us even during the storm. You will protect us, and you will help us. Heavenly Father, likewise, in the storms of our individual lives, dear God, we bring those requests, those circumstances to you, those who might have health challenges. I pray, dear God, that you would touch them, dear God, at the point of their need. Heavenly Father, those who might be experiencing pain, I pray, dear God, that you would quell that pain. Give them complete deliverance today in the name of Jesus, and that they would give you all the glory and all the honor and praise. They will testify of your goodness to them. Heavenly Father, those who might be having financial challenges, I pray, dear God, that you'd give wisdom. Heavenly Father, help, dear God, that we would be able to be good stewards of what you give to us, each and every one of us, because you provide, you continue to provide for us. But help us, dear God, to be good stewards. Not only good stewards, but we would reach out a helping hand, dear God, to those who might be in need. We would not turn a blind eye to those in need, but we would reach out and help them. And as we help them, dear God, they would see the light in us. Your light shining through, dear God, that they would come to know you as Lord and Savior of their lives as well. Heavenly Father, I also pray, dear God, for our leaders. Heavenly Father, I pray that there would be leaders that would prove themselves to be upright, not ashamed, but rightly dividing your word, dear God, our spiritual leaders, and even the leaders of our country. We pray, dear God, that you would, God, give them guidance. They would look to you, who is their eternal help. And they would understand that it is you, dear God, that they should seek guidance and direction, even in leading your people. Pray, dear God, for the one who would speak your word today. Heavenly Father, as you minister through him, dear God, we pray, dear Father, that you would give us receptive hearts for your word. Dear God, prepare our hearts for your word, not only to receive it, but, dear God, that we would act upon it. We would take the appropriate action, dear Father, and we would go out and, dear God, minister to those lives that are wandering lost in this world. I pray, Father, that we would continue to be lights. We would live lives of example before them, that they would come to know you as Savior as well. We pray, dear God, that you continue to bless us through this service. And we give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. I want to say to you in the sanctuary this morning and to our viewers online, on behalf of our pastor, Reverend Lennox Boyce, assistant pastor, Minister Patrick Bellamy, our ministry leaders, I want to say a pleasant good morning and welcome to our online viewers and to the saints again in the sanctuary. This is the Church of God Reformation Movement in Silver Sands Christ Church, Bridgetown, Barbados. We are excited to share our service with you today, acknowledging that our God is worthy of glory and of honor, and indeed worthy of all our praises. May your hearts be blessed and encouraged throughout the rest of our service. At this time, I want to invite back Sister Naomi Williams as she comes to render a special ministry for us this morning. Sister Naomi.
As I come to bring you this song, I reflect on all that God has taken me through in my life. And this song is entitled My Tribute. You know it as To God Be the Glory. And we really want to, I really want to give God the glory and honor and praise that is due to his name for all that he has been to me in my 54 years. My tribute. I say thanks for the things you have done for me, things so undeserved, yet you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude and all that I am and ever hope to be. I owe it all to thee. To God be the glory. To God be pleasing, Lord, unto thee. And should I gain any praise, let it go to Calvary. To God be the glory.
God, yes. Thank you, God, yes. Thank you, God, yes. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Amen, amen. I want to say to you, in life's tapestry, woven with care. The attitude of gratitude is a gem so rare. For in each day's dawn and twilight hush lies the power of thanks, a heartfelt rush. With our hearts open wide, let us always embrace the blessings we find in each day's grace. Amen, amen. God is good all the time. To God be the glory. To God be the glory. It is great to see each and every one of you. I see the sanctuary is filling up nicely this morning. We were at Gardens last week, many of us, and I saw many of your faces, and I was happy to see many of your faces. We turned out well to join our brothers and sisters in Christ down at Gardens last week, yes, and it was a lovely service. They welcomed us with open arms like we welcome them here in our sanctuary with open arms because we are one. Are we not one? Yes, we are. We are one. We are one. Amen. 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 Again, let me take it from the top. In life's tapestry, woven with care, the attitude of gratitude, a gem so rare. For in each day's dawn and twilight hush lies the power of thanks, a heartfelt rush. With open hearts, let us always embrace the blessings we find in each day's grace. In gratitude glow, our spirits soar, for there's always more to be thankful for. Yes? Amen. Amidst life challenges and trials we face, gratitude beacons light up to the space. In thankfulness, our troubles grow small, and in the warmth of gratitude, we stand tall. So let us remember as the days unfold, the treasures we have, more precious than gold. In this world of wonder, in every latitude, let's live each moment with an attitude of gratitude. Amen? Amen. This morning's speaker is none other than our own, Minister Michael Husbands. Praise the Lord. He is a hard worker, always willing to help, a knowledgeable man, jovial, a leader. Husband, father, friend, and confidant, Minister Michael Husbands is a passionate orator, especially in his sermons as it pertains to the things of God. Please welcome Minister Michael Husbands as he comes to speak to us this morning on our attitude to gratitude. May your hearts and minds be of good ground to receive the message of God. And as the word of God declares, it never returns nil and void. Amen. Minister Michael Husbands.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to say good morning. Good morning, church. I want to say good morning again. I want to say good morning to those joining us online. God is good. And all the time, praise the Lord. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, Lord. Even as we go into your word, Lord, it is our prayer that thy will be done, Lord. Father, even as you've been with me in the preparation of your word, Lord, let it now go forth, Lord, with power, with conviction, Lord. But more importantly, Lord, let those that hear also be doers of the word, Lord. Father, we commit this word into your hands. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. God is good. Our topic, brothers and sisters, today is our attitude of gratitude. Praise the Lord. I don't know about you, but I had a rough week. What a week. Because brothers and sisters, by Friday, when Tammy was ready to pass, I was ready to go home. Because of the week I was having, I was happy to get a break. But when I was waiting for the shutdown to come, no shutdown ain't come. So I said to myself, what's going on here? So I gone on Google, you know, and I searching up. Tammy is a category 1 hurricane with sustained winds of 80 miles per hour. And I saying, well, there should be a shutdown. I should be able to go home too. No shutdown. But then I remembered, 2 weeks ago, I was in Antigua. And I remember a tropical storm passed and hit Antigua while I was in Antigua. So I was actually there for work. And the passing of the storm caused all power to go out. And I remember sitting in my room saying, you could believe I fly all the way from Barbados to go to Antigua for a storm? But it was then and there that I remembered why I was there. Because I was there for work. So brothers and sisters, by the Thursday, we were able to pull it all together and execute what I had gone to Antigua to do. So then I reflected on it on Friday. And I said, you know how easy it is to be ungrateful? It is so easy. And I said to myself, you know how many times it has been that we sit and think like I did? But brothers and sisters, I want to say to you this morning that it is good to be here this morning. It is good to be able to deliver the word of God. Because the word of God tells us in Hebrews 10:25, do not forsake the assembling, which means we are to assemble. But furthermore, it is a word written to encourage us to come together, to encourage each other. And when we assemble as the body of Christ, we are supposed to encourage one another, stir up one another in love, and encourage one another in faith. I hope, brothers and sisters, that this morning, this sermon finds you well. Because I want to provide a word of encouragement to you today. Amen? Brothers and sisters, as we look at the topic or attitude of gratitude, I will begin as always with definitions. The word attitude is a noun, and it speaks to a settled way of thinking or feeling about something or someone, and it is typically reflected in a person's behavior. It says she took a tough attitude towards other people's indulgences. So if you look at similar words, it speaks to a point of view, a vantage point, a frame of mind. But then let's also look at gratitude, because it's also a noun. And it says the quality of being thankful, a readiness to show appreciation for and to return kindness.
And it says she expressed her gratitude to the committee for their support. And when we're looking at similar words, we look at words like gratefulness, thankfulness, appreciation, and recognition. So as I formally begin this morning's sermon, I want to ask a question. What are you grateful for? I want you to do something for me this morning. I want you to just breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. The fact that you are able to breathe in and breathe out, you should be thankful for that. What are you thankful for this morning? Are you thankful for life? Are you thankful for strength? Are you thankful for health? Are you thankful for wealth? Are you thankful for your children? Are you thankful for your family? Are you thankful for your friends? Are you thankful for food? Are you thankful for shelter? What are you thankful for this morning? Praise the Lord! Because Psalms 150 verse 6 tell us, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Because everything that breathes should give its praise to the one who gave it breath. Every breath that is given to you is a gift that is given by God. And the praise is worthy to the one who gave the gift. Brothers and sisters, our attitude should be an attitude of gratitude. Today, I'm going to use a very familiar passage from the Bible to take us through today's scripture. And our focus today is on the story of the 10 lepers and their interaction with Jesus. Indeed, the word of God tells us in Luke 17, verse 11 to 19, and I'll read it for you. It says, now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. And as he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. And when he saw them, he said, go show yourselves to the priests. And as they went, they were cleansed. Verse 15 says, one of them, when he saw that he was healed, came back, praising God in a loud voice. And he threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner? Then he said to him, rise and go. Your faith has made you well. Hallelujah. This is the word of God. Our discourse today will look at this passage in 3 distinct parts. It will look at the plea. It will look at the pledge. But it will also look at the praise. Hallelujah. Let me begin by first speaking about the plea. Let me set the stage and give you some background. Now, Jesus was in teaching mode. Because if we look at Luke 17, verse 5 and 6, it says, his apostles were asking him, can we increase our faith? And Jesus said to them, if you have the faith of a mustard seed, you can say to this mulberry tree, be uprooted and planted in the sea, and it will obey you. But then Jesus went on to share not only this story, but also he changed it into a parable as well. Because Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem, and he was traveling along the border between Samaria and Galilee. So as he was walking with his apostles, traveling to Jerusalem, you may ask me, Brother Don, why is this significant? Thank you for asking. Because this was Jesus' final journey. And he knew that in the city, he would meet opposition. He would meet betrayal. He would meet death. But ultimately, he would also meet resurrection. Because Jesus was on a course. And that course would take him to Jerusalem, where he would die according to God's plan. But it says, as he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. And they stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. Jesus was on his way to fulfill God's plan as he passed by these 10 lepers. Brothers and sisters, because they had leprosy, they cried out from a distance. But you may ask, what is leprosy? And how does someone get leprosy? Brothers and sisters, while deep in study, I found that leprosy happens when a person catches something called Hansen's disease. So it is by coughs or sneezes that a person breathes, and then you breathe in the droplets that contain the bacteria. But it also says prolonged close contact with someone with untreated leprosy over many months is needed to catch the disease. So you don't just catch it so. It says prolonged. Prolonged. But what does it look like? So your skin breaks out in patches. There's numbness. There's tingling of the feet, arms, and the legs. But brothers and sisters, in that time, due to a lack of knowledge, those persons were made to live in a leper colony. It was a colony that was set up outside the city walls. So they had to go show themselves to the priest. The priests would say that they were unclean, therefore they could not be within the city walls. But in that time, leprosy was feared as a highly contagious disease. But we know today that it does not spread from person to person easily. But even as Jesus was passing by, what did they do? They called for help. Let me say that again. As Jesus was passing by, what did they do? They called for help. Jesus, Master, have pity on us. Brothers and sisters, the Bible does not tell us how long they were in that state. The Bible does not tell us what else they had tried before Jesus passed by. The Bible does not tell us whether or not they had tried many things and failed. But what the Bible tells us, that when Jesus was passing by, they called out to him. Brothers and sisters, why would they call out to Jesus? Did they see him heal somebody before? Did somebody tell them that he was a healer? Were they, as we say in Belgium, were they trying to think? What other options did they have? But brothers and sisters, I want to say to you today that they called out to Jesus. That is important. But you know what is more important? He heard them. Hallelujah. They called out to Jesus, and Jesus stopped. He was on his way. He was about to be betrayed. He was about to be crucified. He was about to be resurrected. But he heard them, and he stopped. He was on his way to Jerusalem, and he stopped. Did Jesus have things to do? Yes, he did. But you know what I love most about that part? The words they said was, and I love these words. They said, Jesus, Master, hallelujah. Because they recognize who Jesus was, who Jesus is, and who Jesus always will be. Oh, hallelujah. He was, is, and will always be Jesus. He, King of Kings. Hallelujah. Lord of Lords. They cried out, Master. Master. Lord, help us. Master, help us. Have pity on us. Have pity on us. Brothers and sisters, when you look at the word pity, pity says feeling of sorrow and compassion that is caused by suffering and the misfortune of others. They cried out because they wanted Jesus to look at their misfortune. They cried out because they wanted Jesus to look at their suffering. They cried out because they wanted Jesus to have compassion. Brothers and sisters, but Jesus was Jesus. The word of God tells us in Psalms 86 verse 15, but you, O Lord, are a God full of compassion and gracious, long-suffering, and abundant in mercy and truth, because Jesus looked upon them with compassion. They cried out in pity, but he looked upon them in compassion. Brothers and sisters, what a wonderful God we serve. Because I want to ask you this morning, how many of you have cried out? How many of you in your time of need have cried out and said, Jesus, in pity, crying out? How many of you have called out to Jesus, not as your first choice, not as your second choice, but as your last resort? How many of you have cried out to Jesus as your Hail Mary? But Jesus sees, hallelujah, and through his compassion, he hears and he answers, hallelujah. He not only hears, he answers. He not only hears, but he stops. He not only hears, but he takes action. He not only hears, but he knows. Hallelujah. He knows that we need his help. But brothers and sisters, I want to warn you this morning. Because how many of us, because of our attitude, fail to reach out? How many of us, because of our attitude, fail to ask for help? How many of us, because of our attitude, fail to say, we need your help? Brothers and sisters, there was a desperation from the leper, but Jesus showed compassion. I'm asking you this morning, are you desperate for him? Are you willing to cry out to him? Are you open to asking for his help? Because our God is a loving God. Our God is a compassionate God. Cry out to him today. Because so many of us, brothers and sisters, suffer in silence. I'm saying to you, don't let an attitude of ingratitude hold you back. Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, as we move now to the pledge, it says to us that when he saw them, he said, go show yourselves to the priests. And it says, as they went, they were cleansed. Hallelujah. He said, go. 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 You are here, and I want you to move from here to there. Go. What happens, brothers and sisters, if you do not move? If you are here and you're supposed to go and you do not go, what happens? You are still here. You did not go. So if you did not go and Jesus said go, you are still standing where you were before. So if I am here and I raise my leg, did I go? If I am here and I raise my other leg, did I go? Till the same place. But Jesus said, go. If I'm sitting and Jesus says, go, and I sit in the same place, did I go? No. You are still in the same place, but Jesus has said to go. But what is amazing, that when Jesus says go, he means go. What is also amazing, Jesus wanted them to transition. Work with me, church. Jesus wanted them to transition from here to here. Could Jesus heal them while they were here? Jesus could have said, healed. He said, no. He said, go. So he wanted them to move from here to there. That's all. Move from here to there. And furthermore, he didn't say, I will heal you when you get there. He said, go. And on the way, hallelujah. Huh? Hallelujah. While they were in transition, hallelujah, they weren't even fully there yet. They were on the way, hallelujah. Jesus said, go. And while they were going, while they were transitioning, while they were moving to where Jesus wanted them to be, he healed them, hallelujah. They did not even have to get there. The fact that they were willing to go, the fact that they were willing to move from the place of where they were in sickness, to a place where Jesus had promised, if you go, I will. I will. So they stepped from here to there. But they didn't even have to fully get there. While they were stepping, hallelujah. While that foot was moving, hallelujah. Jesus was saying, healed. Healing even in the transition. You may not be fully there, but Jesus is saying, go, and I will heal you while you are going. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is the word of God. Because he is able to move you from here to there and heal you while you're going through the journey. But he also said something important. Hallelujah. Work with me this morning, church. He said, after you go, you got to show. Work with me, church. Not only do you go, but you show. He didn't say go and tell. He said go and show. Hallelujah. He didn't mind if you tell, but show too. Work with me, church. Because he said, let them see. Oh, praise the Lord. Let them see with their own eyes. Let them know that you were a leper. Let them know. Let them know that you were. You were a leper. But let them see that you have been healed. The same priest who put you out, the same priest who called you unclean, the same priest who put you in the leper colony, go back to them and show them what God can do. Go back to them and show them that this man Jesus is able to heal and restore. Go and show. Let the priest verify that you are clean. Let the priest verify that you can come back into the society. Let the priest verify that you can be restored to your families. There was restoration found by showing. Brothers and sisters, show. And let them know that you, me, we were once sinners. Show. And let them know that you are now saved. Let them know that that hard-ass little boy or that hard-ass little girl is now a man or woman of God. Let them know today, because when you go and you show, God will get the praise. I'm saying to you that when you show rather than tell, you make that person a part of the experience. So rather than having to tell them about it, it is imparted to them and they see it through their own eyes. They can form it in their own mind, but also they can come to their own conclusions. So seeing really is believing. What could be better, brothers and sisters, than giving those persons an active role in the experience? Go and show. But Jesus could have said, brothers and sisters, right here, right now, you are healed. I don't want you to do anything. That's it. Healed. You are healed. But he said to them, go and show. But I want to remind you that that's not all. Because there's more. Hallelujah. The word of God says, as they went, work with me, church. As they wait. Not as they did not go. Not as they went when they feel like. Not as they stood in the same spot. Not as they disobeyed. It says, as they went. Jesus spoke. Work with me. Jesus spoke, and they went as instructed. Jesus spoke, they went. Brothers and sisters, I remember a joke when I was at the Cajun Parish School, when they were talking about, you know, speaking proper English. And they said these two boys were having a conversation. And the boy said to the other boy, let us go to town. And the other boy said to him, you need to speak proper English. So he said to him, it is not let us go. It would be we went to town. So the boy said, oh, okay, I understand. So as the bus was coming, he said, us bus is coming. Let us get in and went. Hallelujah. Did you went? I'm asking you today, brothers and sisters, when Jesus spoke to you, did you wait? Because he told you to go. Some of us don't go, we wait. He is asking you to go, but we don't want to follow that instruction. We say, no, I can't go. But it says, as they went, they were healed. Healing. Healing. Because Jesus was able to heal them and heal them fully. This is the God that we serve. Brothers and sisters, David put it in this way. Psalms 30 verse 2. He says, Lord, my God, hallelujah. I called for your help. I cried out to you. And you did what? You healed me. Hallelujah. He heard the plea. But he also can and will heal us. But it must be his will. Oh, but I go a little further this morning, brothers and sisters. Because I'm saying this same Jesus that was able to restore the lepers is also able to restore you. But brothers and sisters, I go further because this Jesus can not only heal in the physical, he can also heal in the spiritual. Hallelujah. I called for you for help, Lord. You heard me and you healed me. I called for you for help, Lord. And the pledge was that he will hear and he will heal. The pledge is that he will answer the call. The pledge is that if you call on the name of Jesus, he will heal you fully according to his will. They called. He heard. They went. They were healed. But brothers and sisters, it ain't over yet. Because what happened next? What did they do? The praise. They cried out, Jesus, we need you. Okay. Go show yourselves and be healed. Okay. They went and were healed. Okay. They looked at themselves. I am healed. Okay. Thanks to Jesus. Thanks to Jesus. Thanks to Jesus. Maybe. Sometimes. When I feel like. Brothers and sisters. Thanks to Jesus. And why? Because our attitude has to be an attitude of gratitude. Because, brothers and sisters, the word of God tells us they all got the same healing. They all got the same healing. There wasn't a special healing. There wasn't a healing for number one and number three that number five and number seven didn't get. They all, A-double-L-L, all, they all got the same healing. But you know what the word of God says? It said one of them, oh hallelujah, one of them, when he saw that he was healed, he came back, hallelujah, praising God in a loud voice, hallelujah. He threw himself on the floor at Jesus' feet and he thanked him. But hold on a minute, he was a Samaritan. He was a Samaritan. Now only one of the 10 came back. You know what he came back to do? He came back to acknowledge that Jesus was Jesus. Work with me, church. He came back to acknowledge that Jesus was Jesus. Because when they cried out at the beginning, Jesus, Master, they needed help. But now, recognizing that he was healed, he came back to acknowledge that Jesus was Master, that Jesus was Lord, that Jesus was the King of Kings. He acknowledged that that is who Jesus is. He returned to the source and acknowledged that his healing came from the source. Hallelujah. I want to say this morning, brothers and sisters, what about you? What about you? Because what is your attitude? Is it an attitude of gratitude? Because, brothers and sisters, our praise should be lifting the roof off the Silver Sands Church of God. Because what God has done for me, what God has done for you, what God has done for us, our attitude should be an attitude of gratitude. Our posture should be falling at Jesus' feet to sing his praises, to praise him. Oh, hallelujah. Can you praise him in your problems? Hallelujah. Going through something difficult, can you praise him? Can you praise those problems away? Problems, praise them away. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, can you praise them this morning? Can I get an amen? Can I get a hallelujah? Can I get a praise the Lord? Can I get a glory be to God? Hallelujah this morning. Our attitude has to be an attitude of gratitude because of what God has done for us. I want to say to you, that when our praises go up, hallelujah, work with me, church, the blessings, oh, work with me this morning. When our praises go up, the blessings come down. Oh, yes, because God inhabits, he lives in our praise. Hallelujah. But brothers and sisters, of all the people, all of them that was healed, who went back? The Samaritan. Now, I don't know if you know, because the Samaritan, if you know the history, and that's your homework, I want you to look up the disconnect that is between the Jews and the Samaritans. Because if you know the history, you will know that the Jews had no dealings with Samaritans. Not them. As a matter of fact, the Jews insisted that Samaritans were not Jews. So therefore, why should they be saved? They regarded the fact that Samaritans worshipped many gods as heresy, as corrupt. But I also want to say to you, when Jesus was healing He didn't heal the 9 and leave out number 10. He healed all, including the Samaritan. And the surprise was that the Samaritan was the only one that came back. Brothers and sisters, when you got it so good that you don't even know that you got it so good, that when you get the healing, you're just running along. But the one who had it hard, work with me, church. The one who had it tough, hallelujah. When the healing come, he can't even recognize, I just left with the healing. He got to come back and say, thank you, Jesus. He got to say, thank you, Jesus, because it was hard. It was rough. Oh, you didn't deserve it, but you do it anyhow. That is the God that we serve. I'm asking you, brothers and sisters, where were the others? Jesus said, I healed them. I restored them. I gave them back all that was missing. But where are they now? Brothers and sisters, I think this is what happened with the 9. I think while they was going, right, they wasn't so sure. But then they recognized, wait, why heal? Let me go down quick. Because they wasn't even sure that they could keep it. So they wanted to make sure quick that they get to the priest. Priest, look, just in case it turned back. But that is not the God that we serve. Because when he says, you are healed, you are healed. When he says, go and show, he means go and show, because he knows. Brothers and sisters, what I love about this is how it ends. Jesus said to the Samaritan, rise and go, for your faith has made you well. Brothers and sisters, 10 called out to Jesus. 10 were healed. 1 came back. The amazing part about this was when Jesus looked at the Samaritan, what he saw was not pity anymore. Work with me, church. This started out by calling out in pity. But when Jesus looked at the Samaritan now, you know what he saw? He saw the faith. He saw the faith of the Samaritan. Oh, hallelujah. He had no transitioned. Work with me, church. He had no transition from a person in need of pity to a man of God who had faith. He had no transition into the place of begging for mercy, from moving from begging for mercy to a place where he had faith in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. And Jesus saw it. Jesus saw it. It wasn't a camouflage. It wasn't a hide up. Jesus could look and see this was a man of faith. Because I'm saying to you, the 9 got the physical healing, but the 10th got the spiritual healing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to say that one more time. Because the 9 got the physical healing, but the 10th got the spiritual healing. Because he was now restored to God. Jesus could look at him. And he could see his faith. I want to say to you this morning, be healed. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. You're not with me, church. I want to say to you this morning, be healed. In Jesus' name. Be healed. In Jesus' name. Be healed. In Jesus' name.
I don't know if you need that healing in the physical, but I'm praying for healing in the spiritual. I don't know if you need your body to be restored this morning, but I'm speaking healing in the spiritual. Hallelujah. Be restored to your God. Be healed in Jesus' name. I want to say to you, you may say to me, Brother Michael, it's all right for you to get up there and talk pretty, but you don't know my challenges. I want to say to you this morning, brothers and sisters, my time is running out, but I wish to talk to somebody this morning. I want to talk to somebody about the days when we had no food in the house but Jesus. I want to talk to somebody about the bills when we had more bills than we could pay but Jesus. Hallelujah. I want to talk to somebody about the health challenges when we didn't know how it would go but Jesus. I want to talk to somebody this morning about catching the bus and praying, Lord, I need a vehicle but Jesus. Hallelujah. I want to talk to somebody this morning about sending my daughter off to school and not knowing how the petty fees were going to be paid. But Jesus, I want to talk to somebody this morning about Jesus because of what he has done for me. That is my God. That is my God. That is my God. I want to talk to somebody this morning about the challenges in your life and what happens when you trust in the Lord. We all have challenges. We all have challenges. But I want to say to you this morning, you may not be able to change the situation, but don't let the situation change you. Work with me this morning, church. Work with me this morning. You may not be able to change the situation, but don't let the situation change you. I'm not sure what you're dealing with this morning, but this is the word that the Lord gave me. I've come and done my part. I'm asking you this morning, of the 10, will you be the one? Will you be the one that has that attitude of gratitude? Jesus didn't write off the 9, you know. He didn't write them off. But you know what he saw in the Samaritan? He saw the faith of the Samaritan. Hallelujah. He moved from a place of pity to a place of salvation, a place of faith, a place of restoration. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because that is who Jesus is. Our attitude must be an attitude of gratitude. Our God hears. Our God answers. Brothers and sisters, are you the one? I want to say to you now, even as I close and even as I look to wrap up, that today is a good day. Today is a good day. Today is a good day. Because even as we are about to do our altar call, we cry out to you today, Lord. We cry out and we say, Lord, hear our plea. Brothers and sisters, don't let him pass you by. Remember what Jesus was going to do. Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem to die. But it didn't finish there, you know. He died and was resurrected. So he died for you and for me. But he was also resurrected so that he could stand at the right hand of God for me
and for you. So that when God looked, he saw Jesus, and we were all covered behind him. Hallelujah. 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 I'm saying to you today, don't let him pass you by. I'm saying to you today, cry out to him. I'm saying today that he hears you and he will respond. Hallelujah. I love this. There's a hymn that we sing. It says, just as I am, hallelujah, without one plea. Because we don't have to have a plea now. We come by faith. Hallelujah. We come by faith. But that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou biddest me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. I come. I'm asking you this morning, if you're here this morning and you don't know Jesus, he is calling to you to come. To come. Stand with me. If you're within the hearing of my voice and you don't know Jesus, I'm asking you, do you want to know him as your Lord and as your Savior? The Word of God tells us in John 14 and verse 6, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no one cometh unto the Father but by me. Brothers and sisters, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, take a real step today. The Word of God tells us that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but will have everlasting life. It says, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. If you are within the hearing of my voice and you want to make a decision today, with all heads bowed and all eyes closed, if you want to make that decision today, you can raise your hand. If you're within the hearing of my voice and you want to make a decision today to answer God's call, I want you to say this short prayer with me. Lord Jesus, I confess my sins and I ask for your forgiveness. Please come into my heart today as my Lord and my Savior. Take complete control, Lord. Take control of my life and help me to walk in your footsteps by the power of your Holy Spirit. We pray this in Jesus' name. We pray. Amen and amen. Brothers and sisters, even as you're standing in the sanctuary and even as you're listening online, I want to pray with you and then I will take my seat. But I want to say to you that imagine that you were one of those 10 who were standing outside the city gates and Jesus was passing by and you had the opportunity to shout to Jesus and to say to Jesus, Jesus, have mercy on me. Jesus, this problem that I've been dealing with, Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I need you. I'm saying to you today, you came here with a challenge, but Jesus is passing by. Jesus is passing by. What I want you to do is I'm going to pray. And even as I pray, I want you to pray about your situation. I want you to call out to Jesus. I want you to speak it. I want you to say to him, Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I need you. I need you today, Jesus, because I've been holding on to this problem too long. I've tried everything. I don't know what else I can do. It is time for Hail Mary. I don't know if you can resolve it, but I've heard of who Jesus is. I don't know if you're able, but I've heard of who Jesus is. And I want to remind you this morning of who Jesus is. Brothers and sisters, reach out to Jesus even as he is passing by. Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, Lord. We come to you this morning, Lord, because you are awesome, because you are mighty, because you are wonderful, Lord. Oh, we thank you this morning, Lord, for your word. We thank you, Lord, that you were able, Lord, to take us through your word, Lord, and to show us, Lord, that even in the time, Lord, of the lepers, you were able to heal. You say, Lord, in your word, that you're the same Jesus yesterday, today, and tomorrow, that you are still in the healing business, that you're still in the restoration business, that you're still hearing your people crying out, you are still hearing your people calling on your name, and you have made us a promise that no good thing you will withhold from us. Oh, this morning, Lord, we cry out to you, Lord. We cry out to you, Lord, because we need you. We cry out to you, Lord, because we know you are still Jehovah Rapha. We know, Lord, that you are still Jehovah Nissi. We know, Lord, that you are still Jehovah Shalom. Oh, this morning, Lord, we pray to you, Lord, knowing and understanding that all we need do is cry out to you, Lord, and you're able to restore, you're able to heal, you're able to take us to that place, Lord, of full restoration, where we can show who God is. Oh, this morning, Lord, we thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your love, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, that in all that is going to be done and all that has been done, that you will get the honor and you will get the glory and you will get the praise. Oh, this morning, Lord, we praise you. This morning, Lord, we glorify you. This morning, Lord, we lift up our voices to you and shout hallelujah. This morning, Lord, we say praise the Lord. This morning, Lord, we say to God be the glory. This morning, Lord, we praise you with all that we have because of who you are. Father, we pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may take your seats. Brothers and sisters. Brothers and sisters. I just want to ask you one simple thing. Can we, God's people, give him praise this morning? We say it, we sing it, but do we mean it? Because this song came back to me. It says, my hallelujah belongs, hallelujah, to you. Nobody else. My hallelujah belongs to you. You know why? You deserve it. You deserve it, Lord. My hallelujah. Our hallelujah. All hallelujahs that there are belong to the one true God. I thank you this morning.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Minister Husbands. Bless you. Thank you for your timely message of encouragement, our attitude to gratitude. Amen. Amen. I want to say to you this morning, rejoice in the divine. Lift your voices high. Sing praises anew beneath the endless sky. Amidst the fellowship of faithful souls, in the harmony our gratitude unrolls. With hearts aligned, in faith we stand, calling to the one who knows each hand. In humble devotion, we shed our old ways, embracing the light of grace that forever stays. We find solace in God's forgiving grace as we seek a fresh start in this sacred place. Through Christ our Savior, our souls are blessed. In his name, our sins find eternal rest. Amen. 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 As we proceed now to our closing of our online service, I have a few announcements for you, and they go as follows. Every Monday, our men's prayer time starts at 5:30 a.m. on Zoom. Every Wednesday, our women's prayer time on Zoom starts also at 5:30 a.m. During this month of October, we will be having National Bible Study, the study of the LGBT, a biblical perspective. The final session will be held in person this evening, October the 22nd, at Chapman Street, 6 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. October is Pastor Appreciation Month. Please take note. Pastor Appreciation Month, October. We still have a few more days in October. The Ladies Church of God will be conducting its final sessions in the sewing classes with Sister Jeremy on Mondays and Wednesdays. This is weekly. 10 a.m. to noon. Started last week. They're saying it's 5 more weeks to go, but still saying last sessions. Here at the sanctuary. That is 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Caribbean Assembly, Atlantic Assembly Day is on Sunday, November the 5th, 2023, online. The speaker, Reverend Courtney Gordon of Jamaica. You can join online on YouTube at CAATV. November 12th, we are going to have a homecoming service, a gathering for all who have ever attended our church. More information will be shared at a later date. November the 19th, we'll be having a cluster Sunday. More information will be also shared on that event at a later date. Strong Groups Building Camp is back. Registration closes on October the 29th. To sign up, email cogstronggroups@gmail.com or call 833-6521. The Priest Within, Saturday, November the 18th at Jackson Church of God, 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. Special invitation to males between the age of 13 and 30 years of age. Our ladies' ministry here at Silver Sands are having an event on the 28th of October. That's a Saturday at 8 a.m. at Heritage Park. It's called Health and Fitness Session, Diet to the Rescue, Reduce Your Risk of Heart Disease. That's 8 a.m. on Saturday, the 28th of October at Heritage Park. Bring a light snack and water. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Church of God Silver Sands, and follow us on Facebook. If you need to contact us, please email us at cogsilversands@gmail.com. As we conclude this sacred time of grace, may you go forth with peace in your embrace. May the love of the divine guide your way and bring you strength and joy throughout each day. May your hearts be filled with kindness and light as you continue your journey day and night. In unity and love, let us all agree to shine God's love for all the world to see. So as you leave this hallowed sacred place, carry with you the spirit of God's grace. May blessings and joy your path attend until we gather together again. Amen.